Welcome to the Dr. Data Show. I'm Eric Siegel. How can you trust AI? That's a pretty important question. As we rely more and more on computers for tasks that are more and more important and complex, how do we know the machines won't screw up? After all, machines are really taking over. Computers decide, or at least help decide, who stays in jail, who gets a loan, who gets hired for a job, which tax refunds are legit, which patient has cancer, and which objects a self-driving car avoids. Now, when our machines take on such responsibilities, we often call it artificial intelligence, but that's a fuzzy term with no agreed definition and can pretty much mean whatever the heck you want it to mean. Instead, there's a better word for it, because in actuality, for automating such challenging decision making, the particular technology that's deployed is machine learning, when computers learn from experience. For example, say you're a bank and you want your computer to help decide which credit card applicants to approve. Suppose that in recent times, you've accumulated the records of 50,000 cardholders and you've noted which of those ended up defaulting and never paying their balance. You want to avoid those kinds of credit card holders in the future, their money down the tube. The list of records, that data, is experience. It's history from which to learn. So now it's time for your computer to do what computers do best, number crunch and optimize. Uncover the patterns and trends so you can classify new incoming credit card requests as well as possible. That pattern discovery process is machine learning. So the ultimate question is, how can we trust that the machine has discovered something valid that what it learned will hold true in new situations never before seen? So, for example, say it finds that credit card holders who are head of household, subscribe to sailboat magazines, and go to the dentist are 5 times more reliable bill payers than average. I like totally made that example up, but it's similar to real insights found by banks. So, assume it has learned a bunch of insights like that, like a few dozen patterns like that. The system sees that these patterns hold true over the 50,000 historical examples it's been analyzing, but how does it know it didn't just find peculiarities to that data set? Trends that are particular to the long list of examples at hand. How does it know these patterns it's discovered actually hold true in general in situations that have never before been seen? I mean, how could such a thing possibly be scientifically validated? That's the ultimate question for machine learning. And the same question applies whether you're trying to train the computer to categorize possible credit card holders, possible criminals, possible tax fraud, or possible objects a self-driving car must avoid. So, the big daunting question is, does what's been learned or discovered from the examples hold in general, or is the system actually too good at learning, so much so that it unearths apparent trends in the given data set that aren't true in general? If it does that, this is a dysfunction known as overlearning. Overlearning is very bad because it basically means it learned incorrectly. So, it turns out that overlearning is actually easy to detect. No fancy math, no advanced science, no deep theory. All you do is hold aside some data for testing. You randomly pull out a sample of data for this purpose and hide it, quarantining it so the machine learning process can't access it, doesn't see it, and can't possibly cheat. Then, once the number crunching is complete and the learning has stopped and the insights are frozen, then they're evaluated on the test data. This serves as an objective measure of how well the insights hold up in general beyond the examples within the data set used to ascertain them in the first place. And that's it. That's the main way we check for reliability in machine learning, the main way we know we can trust its performance will hold strong. I'm Eric Siegel. Thanks for watching. Hit like and share this video if you think your friends are also wondering how you can trust AI. And for access to the entire web series, go to thedrdatashow.com.
Who's your data?
Data. predictive analytics can help you with decisions. You can call, mail, credit, or hire with precision. On Law, Love, and Life, you can prognosticate whom to investigate, incarcerate, set up on a date, or medicate. Charlie Brown never gets his kicks. That's why every old dog needs a brand new trick. If you get sick of chasing sticks or clicks with just a quick fix, you need to learn to predict.